We can't stay down here. Someone must go to the nest eventually. Just how are we supposed to worship the Sky Mother from among the weeds, hmm? This is a disgrace.
Calm yourself. We should be grateful that she protected us from the Winged Terror. Besides, even here we have a visitor. A vision from the goddess herself? What a rare and fortunate blessing.
You hear this, Wag?
Relax, Anuin. I'm sure he meant nothing by it. Forgive my consort. She's been rather excitable of late. This is not, as you seem to recognize, our actual temple. It's merely a shrine we've set up after the business with the dragon. Why, she's the goddess of song, art, the sky, and maternity. She's gentle and brilliant, speaking to her followers in dreams, inspiration, and birdsong. It is said that she wears a cloak adorned with a feather from every bird known to Kith or Wilder, and that she manifests in the flocks themselves.
Aye, and in the screams of childbearing, which I can assure you is not so beauteous a thing.
This is true, which is why midwives are widely considered clergy of Helia, as are many artists and poets. In any case, those of us who follow her feel closest to her splendor in a place where we might share light, song, and a view of the blessed sky.
My thoughts will be as silent as my feet.
Carrying too much weight.
I'll tinker with that. What could go wrong? All done. I'll tinker with that. What could go wrong?
Carrying too much weight.
I can do that. Now this is interesting. Charge!
Carrying too much weight.
Gods, it's gotten hard to concentrate. You shouldn't be here, Traveler. And the others of my clan won't be so lenient if they find you sneaking around. Rimurgon's domain. A place where all things are mingled like snowflakes in a blizzard. It's a vortex of such chaos that even the Beast of Winter himself could not calculate the trajectory of the infinite particles of essence there. As souls are broken down over successive reincarnations, they become part of the White Void. It is a place where all things find perfect unity and freedom. The Frosthewn Breach is a weak spot in the barrier between us and the White Void. Thin ice on a frozen lake. We've come from the white that wends to find it. So that we can die permanently. We've lived more lifetimes than any mortal should. We've been faithful followers of Rimurgon since our earliest incarnations. He's the god of entropy. Why would he force us to be reborn again and again? But if anything could pass through the Frosthewn Breach, it would enter directly into the White Void. This death is overdue for us. We just have to find a way through.
I'll tinker with that. What could go wrong?
Carrying
too much weight. Hey, look what I found. Charge! Sorry, I don't...
Onward!
Margrin's fire casts light in dark places.
I'll tinker with that. What could go wrong?
Onward!
Charge! I can do that. All done.
Hounds. Loyal to a fault without a mind of their own, and a cro-
Builder's wisdom to you.
Arensi has no right to defend that cowering cat in the back of the maw.
Then track her down and tell her yourself.
Come to see the great Oernos, Estremor? He's out for a hunt, but he'll be back. Unlike that lioness.
Kareth, this is no place for sights.
Because she holes up at the back of the maw, surrounded by her pride and the natural hazards of this place. It's not the proper way to meet a challenger. She's got to come out and face Oernos to keep her claim. Anyway, her prime is past. Putting that old beast down would be a mercy at this point.
We wait for the big confrontation, but the wait grows exhausting.
while Sul hides in the back of the Maw. Oernos has denied his victory, and we're all denied the champion we deserve.
Tread carefully, Estremor.
Am I the only one here starting to nod off? Rain might be in order.
The better part of...
All done.
Thank you.
Now what's this all about?
Let's keep quiet.
If you stand on the side of that toothless old bag of bones, then you stand in my way.
Starting to slow the pack. Can we sit for a spell and relax?
Greetings, Estramor. You are among the Ovates of the Golden Grove, and turned your turbulent passions against me, no doubt. What is a god that his voice should carry so far? And what are you that you should so eagerly obey? The gods only have dominion over what we seed, and you would seed matters of life and death to them.